Hi, everyone. Thank you so much for joining our Tips from the Top on Thursdays. And my name is Sabrina Rare. I'm the training manager here at VO1 Hope. And we have Jes Landau joining us today to give us some tips on how to prepare for January and the holidays. So we're going to let her take it from here. Hi, Jes.
Hi. Thanks for having me. Okay, so... As I told everyone before, before this started, I am not yellow, so I'm not the most organized person. So I'm just going to kind of talk and feel free to chime in and ask questions and tell me if what I say makes sense or not. I own the fact that I'm incredibly scattered. And so any sort of organization that I have, I feel really proud of, but I am not color coordinated. I don't have one list in one place. It's kind of all scattered everywhere. So hopefully what I say kind of translates. I guess, though, the biggest tips that I would kind of give you, A, getting ready for the holidays, and B, thinking ahead. Kendra, who is my upline, who most of you guys probably know who she is, she did this awesome call with us about getting ready for Q4 also. And a big thing that she did, and it was one of those tips that even I need to do better on, is she talked about really looking at your calendar and putting everything in your calendar that actually has nothing to do with One Hope first in there. Q4, if you guys haven't been in Q4 yet with us, with One Hope or with other direct sales companies, it's really, really, really exciting because you, Sabrina, why are you making that face at me? Oh.
I'm excited.
I was like, is it not called Q4? Okay.
No, so, Q4.
Okay. I got nervous. I was like, oh my gosh, the wrong name. Okay. So basically, in all retail sales, up to maybe 70% of all sales can happen in Q4. And so that's why people get really, really excited for October, November, December. Obviously, for us right now, October is extra exciting for those of you who are going for Mexico because of those double points. Oh, hey, Kat, I'll see you there, girl. I see you. First drinks on me because it's all inclusive. but the first thing is really go into that calendar. Like I actually, this is really yellow of me, you guys. I have two calendars now, two, because this one ends in December. So I had to get a new one to start going into January. So everyone should like give me a gold star for that. But really go in there, add everything like holiday parties that you have to go to. If your spouse has a holiday party that you have to go to, the stuff at the school. I mean, Ella's school has so many random things that I don't even know. Like, it turns out I had to go to some reading math thing the other day. I had no clue. Wasn't on my calendar because I'm not very good at that. So I'm going to tell you guys, put everything on your calendar. And then from there, actually circle out when you can do tastings because Q4, you're really, really, really going to want to have that balance. Another thing that I do, and you probably guys, this has probably happened for a lot of you, is building up into the holidays. People kept saying like, well, just let me know in the holidays, like I'll host with you in the holidays. Now is the time to really make sure that you're following up with those people, because if they do want to push off again, you can now start thinking about January. Kelly Harrick calls it looking at down her pipeline and like really seeing the future. So I personally try to go out 90 days at minimum with my calendar, if not more. So right now I'm actually looking all the way into January. I have two people so far who are ready to host. We just have to finalize their date. One really cool thing that I did not know about, and this was one of my hosts for January told me this, is that there is actually a day that is considered like the most depressing day in all the land. And it's like in the middle of January, people have the winter blues. So I would tell all of you to go book a tasting on that day because people are going to need to be social. Just Google it. I don't even remember what it was. I want to say it was like January 20th, maybe somewhere around there. But you can really start thinking all the way that far out. If somebody says to you, you know, maybe during the holidays, like I would tell them, okay, I'm going to call you back actually in a couple weeks because I'm already starting to book into the holidays. I get that it's October and we haven't even gotten through, you know, Halloween, but like I'm planning my schedule. I have Thanksgiving coming. I have my family travel coming. So let people know when you're going to call them back. Just say like, I'm going to call you that last week of October because I am finalizing 2017 and I'm going to start booking already into 2018.
And that way it gives you a reason to let them know that you're going to reach out to them. The two people who have already talked about doing January, there you go, January 15th, boom. Oh, you all know it. You all know it. Look at you guys go. Okay, see, it's not the 20th. Good thing I didn't tell you. Google. I don't know if I can Google why I lied at the same time, or not live, Zoom. I have no idea. Whatever, not yellow. I forgot what I was saying, but something about January. And so one of them I did tell that I was going to reach out to them middle of October, that I'm going to be reaching out to them in January. And then the other one, she said she wants to do January. And she was one of the people who totally wanted that holiday tasting. And she's already pushed me back. She's the one who told me about the bluest day in all the land. I told her I'm going to be reaching out to her beginning of December because I don't want to have to get through the holidays thinking about it. I want it to just on my calendar. We can both be back from the holidays ready to go for it. Does all that make sense? Is this helping? Yes? No? I mean, I feel like the best thing I've told you so far is there's Blue Monday.
You've gone a little quiet. I don't know.
Oh, you can't hear me?
It's just, you sound far away.
Can you hear me now?
Yeah.
It's all the same.
Did you like adjust something? Like move your computer or something?
I moved it because it was falling down. Is that better?
Yeah, there was a ripping, a little bit better.
Can you guys hear me at all?
We can hear you. It's just you're not quite as close.
Oh, I'm not really moving.
Here we go. There we go.
Is that better?
Yeah, that's better.
I mean, I don't know where the microphone is on the computer. Yeah, not yellow. It's there though. It's on there somewhere. Oh, so Kaz, you said I went quiet too. Awesome. Sorry. But those are kind of my big tips is really letting yourself go all the way into January, letting people know when you're going to actually reach out to them. Don't leave it open-ended. It's kind of the same that when you go into your calendar and you circle all the dates that you have available, always offer the closest ones that are available to you so you can book in tight as close as possible. So like for me right now, my next open dates I already know are November 3rd and November 5th. So that's all I'm offering to people. Once those book, then I will be offering, you know, November 5th and December 1st because my November is already booked out. Start looking into January. There is nothing worse than coming off the holiday high and not having anything on the books for January. And you literally just word it, you know, I don't want you thinking about your holiday over your holidays when we're going to do this. Like, let's just do the date. We'll come back from the holidays. We can order your wine. Everything's set. You'll be able to see all the friends that you didn't get to see during the holidays, the parties that you weren't able to attend because your kids took over your life, whatever it is. But, you know, make it sound like you're doing them the favor by booking into January and getting it ready for them. And even in the holidays, you know, anyone who says the holidays is busy, this is the time to bring everyone to you so you don't have to go to them. Kaz agrees. I saw her head nodding. Kaz is the queen, so whatever Kaz says goes.
I think you're onto something there, like the giving two dates and telling people when you're going to reach out to them so that you're in charge of the conversation. I think that's huge because then you can also, you know, tell them when you're going to follow up. Like once they book the date, tell them, you know, follow up, tell them when you're going to reach out to them again to let them know when they're ordering their wine and when to send out the invites and all that. So I think that's great. You know, owning that conversation and making sure that you follow through on the dates that you say you're going to follow through on.
100%. I think
it's an experience.
Yeah, I think that's for all aspects of your business, whether it is you're reaching out to someone for corporate gifting or nonprofits or somebody that you want to build for your team of impact, like letting them know if someone says, even for building my team, if someone says not timing's not good right now, I'm like, okay, well, I'm going to reach out to you, you know, when we have our next sign-up special. So you at least know what's going on. I'm going to keep you in the loop. But yeah, the reality is your business is more important to you than anybody else. So if you rely on somebody else to pick a date or to actually make it happen, it's not going to happen. It's kind of like, I'm the queen of this. Like when I go out to dinner and someone says, well, what do you want to have? I'm always like, well, what do you want to have? Like somebody just make a decision and like, you have to be the one to make the decision. It's your business. Dinner, you don't have to do that. You can put it on the other person. So, any questions, anything I can help with? I don't, Anything I missed? It's so weird that I'm the only one talking. You guys are all muted.
You can unmute yourself if you have any questions or want to chime in. Definitely.
I mean, please do. Otherwise, I'm just kind of hanging out staring at you guys.
Okay, I'm gonna chime in as well. Last January was, I think, a bit of a shock for a lot of us because we'd had a really busy season. October, November, December was just really, you know, crushing it. And then January hit, and I had parties on my books, and I probably could have done a better job at following up with my hosts about that. Like Jess was saying, you know, just wait till the holidays, wait till Christmas and the New Year's over, and then check in with those hosts, get their wine, get it going. But I think sometimes people just are kind of done with partying. And so you really have to find a way to get them back on board with getting together with friends in January. I found that quite a few of my parties rescheduled. So I'd done a good job at booking my calendar, like Jess was saying, but they rescheduled. So you want to engage them. You want to really get them thinking passionately about the nonprofit that they're supporting with their party. Get them involved in the as much of the process as you can, kind of just get them hooked in it. And that way those tastings are going to stick. And even if it's just four people rather than the 14 that you are hoping for, planning for, still do it. Because people need to restock their wine cellar in January. They've drunk everything over the holidays. And so they need to refill. Another part of it is January is the time where a lot of people give up drinking because they've been drinking over the holidays and they're in this new health kick and they're starting to go to the gym and they're eating healthily and they're not drinking. And so, you know, that we kind of need to respect that part of it, but we can still talk about getting together for a wine tasting and doing like mini sip tasting, which is even a tiny, tiny taste of wine. And then they can kind of stock up for Valentine's Day, whatever holidays are coming up. And still support the nonprofit. So there's kind of a lot to January that makes it different from the rest of the year. That makes sense.
I totally agree.
And I know that we currently have a great incentive for the incentive trip going on. We have the suitcase challenge going on. But just like last year, keep in mind there may be an incentive starting January 1 as well. So there is always going to be a reason to book, sell, and recruit. So just a little tip from me and home office. Can't say much else, but I can say that it's definitely what?
That was a big tip.
So there's definitely like booking, thinking of your January is going to be big benefits from it. You know, and I know that we're all really gunning for that Mexico trip because it's going to be so much fun, but definitely continue and think into your January and February. You know, if your January might be a little slow, think of your February for, you know, love parties or for, you know, Valentine's Day and date nights. And we also have the amazing wine club now. So if you sell now, that could, the second shipment could be in January and February. So definitely start thinking about that and how you can capitalize on that second shipment. Yes.
I would also think of maybe even, you know, for October for me, it was actually really hard to get people to book still. People were still kind of in the whole mindset that they were coming back to school and there was too much going on. So I actually tried to think outside the box of who I was having actually host this month. Which is kind of where I'm thinking for January also. So I did like private events at stores where they had like their VIP people come. I actually have two guys hosting this month. Two. I've never had a guy host. I have two, literally, tomorrow and Saturday. So I think it's just a matter of trying to get yourself to think differently also in January, like maybe there's just other people in different ways that you can think of also there's New Year, so you can have that idea of like bringing everyone together, and maybe people who didn't do gifts during the holidays, you can then get them to do gifts in January instead, just to get yourself going. Because as Kaz said, January was, it was intense last year. And I had tastings also, and they were all canceled. So it's all good though.
So something else that you can do definitely for January is plan on having a couple of tasting events yourself at your house, at Clubhouse, if you're in an apartment complex or something like that. That way, at least you're not relying on someone else to host and potentially cancel. And when you're talking with folks during December and into the beginning of January, then you've got those dates in place, maybe one up towards the beginning of the month and one in kind of mid to second half of the month. And that way you've got something to invite them to. You've got specific dates that you can say, hey, you know, once holiday, the madness and the rush is over, I'm having a couple of wine tastings in January to kind of kick off the new year. Come on over and just try some. And that way you've got something to look forward to, even if everything else goes south. You've got yours that you can rely on doing.
And you can also do a customer appreciation event. Mm. You know, any past customers from the holidays, you can, you know, grab some of those reserve wines and taste those at your event as a special treat for your past customers. Anyone that buys holiday gifting, you can give them a special treat. So I think that sparked an idea when you started talking, Kaz. I think that you know, after the holidays, people might just want to kind of relax and do a small wine tasting and not have to host. So if you host one, I think that's a great idea. Takes the pressure off your guests.
I agree. I'm also, this is totally random, but I've started thinking about January because clearly I'm on this call. Kaz, I might be coming to Colorado in January.
Yes. All right.
And usually, and this is what actually I did in July too. July was a tough month for me to book. And so I actually went home to Colorado and booked tastings there because those people knew I was only going to be there for X amount of time. So if they wanted to do a tasting, it was then. So maybe if you're traveling anywhere, Tracy, that means you too. Yes, nod. I know you're distracted by somebody else. It's okay. I love them. Hi. that might be a great way to get people to commit to a date, because if you are going to be in town or traveling somewhere for that one little bit, take advantage. Colorado, they don't even know it, but I'm coming.
Bring the suitcase. Not that you'll have it.
I mean, Lori will probably have it. So I'll have to come visit anyways. It's all good.
Well, these are some great tips. Does anyone else have any great ideas? Kaz and Jess have provided some awesome ones. Anyone else?
What about like the New Year's Day hair of the dog wine tasting?
Ooh, little mimosa. Mimosa action, that'd be awesome. That's a great idea. Maybe a couple days after.
After you send the kids back to school, we can like celebrate again. I know that sounds so mean. I'm sorry. It's like, I'm not a Pinterest mom. I'm so Amazon Prime.
Does anyone else have any great ideas? Come on, people chime in.
I don't know if it's like great idea or not, but I think it's important to just remember to pace ourselves. Like, it's not a sprint. We're all going to be in this for the long haul. And decide how many tastings you want to do a month and let that be your guide. And so if you decide you only want to have, you know, not only, but if you decide you want to have four and you booked up your November and you're into December, then book four then. And if those are full, book into January. Don't pressure yourself to do them all when everybody's telling you to do that. They're saying that they want to do them, you know, decide ahead and just pace yourself, be steady, be consistent. You can't win a marathon or finish a marathon if you're constantly sprinting. You've got to pace yourself. So I don't know if that's.
I think that's a great reminder. especially during the holidays. After December, you're going to be exhausted, but definitely if you pace yourself and have a couple tasting events planned, you know, maybe host one yourself and, you know, have your follow-up list ready for the holiday, from the holidays. That also following up in January is going to be huge, so that you know that your customers enjoyed the wine, or, you know, you can hear the positive impact it's making for the gifts that have been ordered. And then you can keep them, you know, on your radar in a couple months to refill. So it's definitely, there's so much, there's going to be plenty to do in January. It's just a matter of booking out and making sure that you have your calendar booked as you want it to be booked. That's a great idea. I like that, Kelly. Anyone else?
If you say that you already booked up November, like, they have no choice but to pick December. And if you've already booked up December, they have no choice but to pick January. So make yourself look busy, even if you're only doing two tastings. They have no choice. Those dates are taken. You're smart. I like it.
Well, awesome call. Anyone else have anything to add? Anyone? Levon's idea of the Q1 wine club tasting. Oh, that's nice. I like that idea. So you would purchase one yourself and then do it for a tasting, so that people could purchase. I think that's a great idea. If you host your own event, have it be the wines that are included in that quarter's wine club, so everyone can order the wine club. That's a great idea.
Super smart.
Yeah. Jess, do you have anything else to add before we close up today's call?
I love your faces. Huh? I love your faces. That's all I got.
Well, thank you so much, everyone, for joining. I'm going to post this recording later today, so feel free to share it. Feel free to rewatch. It should be the month before it's due to ship out. So I know our team's working on it right now.
Thank you, Sabrina.
Yeah, thank you. Have a great day, everyone. We'll see you next week.
Bye.